Nancy and Ken and Richard with what I put forward for ministry. And we can all pray for anybody that would like prayer. But before we do that, there's a couple people, and how many of you guys know what prophecy is? Anybody know what prophecy is? I know one person knows what prophecy is. Anybody know what prophecy is? It's one of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And prophecy, by nature, is foretelling, but really, the Bible defines prophecy as the testimony of Jesus. It's simply repeating what Jesus thinks about you. Repeating what Jesus is saying about you. It's nothing weird, it's nothing wrong, it's New Testament prophecy is the testimony of Jesus. And the thing about New Testament prophecy is you're supposed to judge and weigh every word spoken. But you're not supposed to judge the prophet. You're supposed to judge the word. And now I'm not a prophet, but I do prophesy.
We have to leave. Oh, you have to leave now?
But the Bible says, judge the prophecy. Judge what's being spoken of each person. So when I say a prophecy, when I give a prophecy, I'm giving a little education on this. When I give a prophecy, what I want you to do is I want you to test that word in your heart. A, what does it say about Jesus? B, does it line up with what God has spoken to me in my life? Because New Testament prophecy should always confirm what God has already spoken to you. How many of you know that you can hear God? You don't need somebody else. You don't need the pastor. You don't need the worship leader. You don't need Ken or Nancy or Richard to hear God for you. You can hear God for yourself. So if we give a word from the Lord, it should always confirm what God's speaking to you. Now there is an application when God says something so wild, so radical, you've never thought of that before. And maybe he already tried to tell you, but you weren't listening, so he used somebody else. But test and weigh that word. Ask the Lord about it. Sit on it. Don't just take it for what I have to say. Sit on it. Ask the Lord. Judge it. And if you feel it resonates in your spirit with what the Lord is speaking, okay, to you, and you believe it's what the Lord is saying to you, then run with it. If not, send me an email. I'll tell you, I'm sorry. I'm so close to that. And it's okay. See, here's the thing. You know, it's okay to make mistakes in the kingdom of God. We don't beat ourselves up when we make mistakes. We just say, okay, I'll learn from that, and I'll grow. Okay? See, that's the difference. We don't beat each other up. We don't freak out. Oh, my God, I made a mistake. No, you just go, okay. Well, I'm sorry I made a mistake, because I'm going to learn from it. Take the lessons I need to grow from it, and go from there. Okay? So I really felt like the Lord wanted to minister prophetically to just a couple of you, and then we're going to pray over everyone, okay? So, this sister here, what's your name? May? As in the month of May? Yes, could you come up here, please? How are you doing, May? I'm Daniel. Nice to see you. And, Can I just see your hand? And I just promise you that Jesus has nothing bad to say. It's all good. And he's not going to tell you, you know, something that you don't... Well, I'm not going to say he's not going to say something you don't want to hear, but I'll tell you, he's not going to say anything bad. Okay? That's something else. We don't ever, you know, in New Testament prophecy, we're not revealing people's bad things and the things that are wrong with them. No, what we're doing is we're pulling the gold out of them and we're revealing what Jesus thinks about. Because Jesus doesn't think anything bad about you. He doesn't. He's very pleased with you. Amen? So, with this sister, May, I just really felt like the Lord was saying to you, May, number one, you're valuable and precious. Looking in the eye and I said, you are valuable and precious. You are valuable and precious. And number two, I just felt like there was a spirit of refreshing coming to you. I felt like there have been people in your life that have like just sucked you dry. And like you feel like every time you're around them, it's like, oh, you know, you feel weak around them because they just suck life out of you. it's not like while they're greatly religious, they take, because you're a strong person and you're a carrier of a lot of things. You like to give things away. That's just who you are. But there's people that have taken advantage of that, and they've depleted a lot of strength from you and a lot. And I just felt like God wants to say, I don't want to focus on that. I want to focus on the back. And Jesus is just saying, I'm coming to refresh you. I'm coming to refresh you. He wants to refresh you in his presence. I want you to be full. I want you to understand that you're powerful. Say, I'm a powerful person. And one of the things that he wants to empower you with is the ability to say no. He's giving an anointing to be able to say no to people when you know that you can't do it. You're the type of person, it's like someone says to do something, you just say, okay, even if you can't do it, that's just who you are. And Jesus is saying, I'm giving you an anointing to say no because you realize you have power. You're a powerful woman. He gave you power. He wants you to be a powerful person. And I just really felt like the Lord is saying, I'm going to grant you the ability to say no to people so that you can maintain the strength and you don't have to feel like somebody else is controlling you. Okay? So with that, I want to just pray for his refreshing for you. Is that okay? Yeah? Can you just put your other hand up, your hands up, that you're going to receive a present? Because Jesus is just going to come with his presence. And we just thank you, Lord. Releasing your presence right now. Hey! More. Shake on. More. All right. This sister here. You know, the Lord said that the trials that you've gone through has produced gold in your life. The fire that you've gone through has produced gold in your life. Gold, 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 gold. And I see you shining brilliantly with gold, gold, gold. You are golden all the way through. And you are loved. You are loved. And you're not forgotten. The Lord says you are not forgotten either. You are not forgotten. He has been with you. He's been with you. He's been the source of strength. And in the midst of the trials, in the midst of the fiery circumstances, he says that he has produced gold within you. He's produced gold within you. And that his presence is coming yet again into your life. Yet again. Yet again. He will still be the strength and the source of everything for you. So we just release your presence, Lord, minister to every need that she has right now. Here's the deal. What I really see is like Lord put wings on you. He gave you wings. And you're created to fly. You're not to let circumstances keep you down. And that's allowed people to keep you there. You need to use your wings. And you need to fly. So what I want you to do, I want you to put your arms out like you're gonna fly. Like you're Superwoman, you know, you're gonna fly. Now, your arms up, you're gonna fly. And the scripture for you is that you'll mount up with wings like the eagles. Isaiah 48. You'll mount up with wings like the eagles. You'll mount up with wings like the eagles. Why? So you can soar. It's time for you to soar. It's time for you to soar above your circumstances and look at the dreams that God's placed in your heart. You're a big dreamer, aren't you? You don't just dream small things. Like you dream big, grandeur, like massive things. That's you. You're a big dreamer. And it's like time to soar to your dreams. Time to soar above those things that try to hold you down. And just say, I'm flying and I'm not looking back. Because I'm going to live the life God created me for. It's time to fly. Amen. So Lord, we just thank you. Give her wings. Beneath her wings to soar. Amen. Cool. This sister here. I remember you from last time, but I'm not good with names. You told me your name earlier. And I've got the names. Your name again? Annie. Yes. Annie. Annie, you're such a mom. You're a mama. You're so much a mom. The Lord just wants to honor you for the years of faithfulness. I just feel like all the Lord says, I want to say thank you to you for being a good mom. Because you're not just a mom to your kids. You're a mom to so many of you. Even to a lot of the women in this room, you're like mama to them. And they look at you and go, oh, it's mama. It's mama. And the Lord just wants to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Papa. Just receive his presence. This sister right here. Hi, what's your name? Marilyn. Alright. Can I just see your hand, Marilyn? And, I just see the Lord coming and really just revealing himself to you in a special way. In unusual ways, his presence is going to be. Oh, that's crazy. That's crazy things. Things that you won't even want to tell people because they'll think you're crazy. That's a good thing, though. Those are good things because that's just the way the Lord is. So, what I see is the Lord coming and visiting you in unusual ways. Ways in which you won't even be able to share with other people because it's just so special. And it's so unusual that people might think you're crazy, but it's also meant just between you and them. And you're going to know how loved you are. Like you think you do, but you really don't know. You're going to have a clue how loved you are. And you're going to start to get the glimpse of how valuable, precious, and how much of a daughter you are. And how he adores you. And he's going to minister to you, and he's going to speak to you about things concerning your destiny. He made you to be, because I feel like those are questions that a lot of times you ask, like, Lord, why am I even here? What did you make me for? I don't know. And then the Lord's going to speak to you, okay? So we just pray for you, and Lord, we just ask that you would come and minister to her, come visit her in a special way. Ask for your presence to her, Lord. In Jesus' name. So at this point, what I'd like to do is I would like to invite Nancy and Richard and Ken and Anna. And for anyone that wants prayer, we'd like to pray for you. We'd like to bless you. Is that okay? Could you guys like that today? Amen? Okay, so I'm going to have Ken and Nancy come forward.